Mr.Pravin Tulpule, sir, is a retired lieutenant commander from the Indian Navy. He is lovingly called as Happy Aunt. He is the entertainer, caring lover of Dr. Lapala. Sir has sought voluntary retirement, foregoing his lifelong pension from the Navy and became Happy the Clown to spread happiness and joy amongst those who are deprived of it. He visits hospitals, hospices, orphanages, and old age homes and shelter homes to bring a smile on the faces of the weary souls and has performed more than 4,000 shows. Sir has recently been awarded Paramvir Chakra by High Congo in association with the United Nations. Bertrand Russell has once said, "The good life, as I conceive it, is a happy life." I don't mean if you are good, you will be happy. I mean that if you are happy, you will be good. Sir firmly believes in this, and I hope everyone thinks of the same after having heard it. So now I would like to ask Mr. Pravin Tulpule, happy actor, to come in.
सत्रह साल देरी में काम करने के बाद एक आदमी क्लाउन कैसे बन सकता है। मेरा नाम प्रवीण टुलपुल है, पहले नेवी में सर्विस करता था, हम लोगों में क्लाउन बन के खुशियां बांटता हूँ। स्कूल्स, हॉस्पिटल्स, ओल्ड एज होम्स, आज तक तकरीबन 4,500 शो मैंने कर दिया हूँ। मैं नेवी में बहुत खुश हूँ, पर हाँ मैं हमेशा ही लोगों को खुश करना चाहता था।
Australia, will you be able to hear me there? New Zealand, yeah? Japan,
so request everyone to come down, occupy the front rows if possible.
So that I don't need to shout a lot. But white uniform was more important.
And the magic happened at that time. And this Pintoo guy who was brought home, who had been re-christened as Praveen on the certificates, became a naval officer and they were all connected together. Right? The magic never left me. It was always there. And the child in me was always connected to the Pintoo guy. You're getting me, ma'am, right? It's a little confusing at times. I don't know how it works. This happens and this happens and this happens and this also happens. Very interesting. All through my naval life, this continued. And then suddenly, one day, I'm called to a party to entertain. All gratis, no money, nothing. A lady, a very nice, well-meaning lady, says, "Pravin, why don't you come and help us? There's a group of children, we are coming there." So I go there, and there I get the shock of my life. I see only small children and all cancer patients. You know what they look like, so I don't have to describe them. And that was a shock. I had never seen, like, this is the first time I'm seeing such a big gathering of doctors together. I'm so lucky. If something happens to me, I'm in good hands. That evening was a different thing. I played around, I did my thing. There was one little child who played around with me. He was so pally and so friendly with me, putting hands in my pocket, touching my bag. So people thought he's one of my props. We took pictures and I was so lucky that guy made me world famous in my coffee club. 2 days later, our pictures were published in the newspapers. And 2 days later, after that, the publishing of the papers, this lady who had called me calls up to say, "Hey Pravin, you know that boy?" He said, "Yeah, he made me famous. I want to thank him." He said, "Yeah, but you cannot thank him because that child is no more." So we dug into a little history and we found out this particular young child, boy, had, like, we have 100 wishes and more. Apart from all the other wishes that he had, he wanted to meet a joker. In India, we don't have clowns, we have jokers. Because the clown word doesn't exist for us, most of us. Shock. Okay, I was there. And that helped me wear this red nose. And this was all connected. This child had never grown up. He was here. He was here, he was here, and now it suddenly appeared that this clown had actually come there. And he had not left the earlier one either. So it was, anybody studying psychiatry here? Oh, I'm so happy. Yeah, you would have judged the other guys. Yeah, I would have this character with me, I would have this character with me, I would have this character with me. This is connected here and this is still there. Oh my God, it's so difficult. This is also connected still here. Really, it's very difficult to keep so many people inside one body. People would laugh at me, says, "What is happening to you?" I said, "I don't know. At times at night, I don't know what I'm doing. And I do it a little more, this thing, and I did." They're still there. You don't understand why they're still there. Come on, go down. And then what happened? What's it? The stress takes its toll and you break up. It happens. But then, I'm not allowed, being a clown, I'm not allowed to take stress. Have you heard about pulling strings? Yeah? I push strings, see? 1, 2, 3, I push it inside. You know, it's very interesting, pushing strings. And if you do that the right way, this guy automatically gets connected here. And then here. And of course, the clown never leaves your focus, he's always there. Normally when I do this, people do wonder what has happened. No, I'm not talking about clapping, don't worry at all. Just joking. But if you want to, you can clap. Can you go to the next slide, please? See? The red nose. My eternal... Can you go ahead, please? What is happiness? You must have perhaps learned various terminologies about it. That's the reason. No psychiatry. See, people, no psychologists here. I'm so happy. Can you go to the next slide, please? There's so many definitions that is given there. I got them from the internet. That is happiness, they say. I'm not going to read it out. You all good at reading better than me. Okay, so I say 1, and a 2, and a 3, and a 4, and a 5, and a 6, and a 7, and the next one. How do I define happiness? That is what internet told me. My happiness is different. I find happiness in spreading happiness. Right? We shall come back to this point again. How does Dr. Laugh a Lot? By the way, you will be wondering, who is Dr. Laugh a Lot? So I am Dr. Laugh a Lot. There it is. Bad manners to turn my back on you. But then unless I turn my back, I cannot show you who I am. So doctor laughed a lot. So I did two things when I started becoming a clown. I first of all called myself happy. And I said, if I am not happy, I cannot spread happiness. An empty bag can give nothing to anybody. So I've got to be happy with myself. And the second thing is, I call my clown character, which goes to the hospitals, as Dr. Laugh-A-Lot. They say, Doctor, heal thyself. I say, Dr. Laugh-A-Lot. I love to laugh a lot. What is happiness? We see, we come to this part again. Can you go to the next slide, please? Yeah, that is it. A feeling that you know everything is good, life is good. When you're good, like I was coming today, there was suddenly a little traffic jam. I was wondering whether I'm giving a little blood pressure to my friend, Dr. Sensei. No, fortunately the traffic eased and we could make it in time. So, I'm happy. Life is good. Things are falling in place. But that's, he felt the same thing at that time. Their life is good. Otherwise people will ask him, where's your guest? He's not done. Right? Can we have a next slide, please? So, I was successful in reaching here. I was safe. Nobody opened the door in the traffic for me. Suddenly. And perhaps I was lucky that I reached it. So I was happy, right? I need to be happy at all times. We'll try to. Can you go to the next slide, please? And one more. Yeah. Now this is a technical question. Please don't go ahead. Right? Why do we laugh? It's getting a little boring here, right? I don't too much of talk. I don't. If you ask a small child, why do you laugh? He'll give you a very innocent question. You tickle me and I laugh. Right? That's an anatomical or a physiological part of it. Why do we laugh? And for that, I need an audience member to come and help me. Not one, not two, I need at least three people, one after the other. Who's going to be the first person to help me? Somebody who doesn't know me at all? I mean, anybody could come actually. Yeah? Nobody? Then I'll have to make a choice by... Yeah, you want to come, ma'am? Yes, please. Good boy. I need one more. Is she coming? Is she going? You don't know, sir. Yes, please. Okay, now I'm feeling a little threatened, so I need a boy. Yeah, of course. Oh, that's... Everybody deserves a big round of applause, right? Who goes in first, ma'am? You go in first with me? Good boy. Thank you so much. So, the rest of you can sit down. Now, earmark so that now they're committed. They can't go back to their seats. Right? So nice. So I'm going to show you something very interesting and don't go nowhere, okay? You're not supposed to look into my bag. This is a wonderful thing that I carry with me because it is one of the best things I have ever worked with. When nothing works, like right now my remote is not working, he's helping me with the slides. When the AC doesn't work, I work with this, ma'am. This way, please. What's your name? Are you married? Really? private job. No, nothing, just a private job. Right? Yeah. It's so beautiful, right? What? What did you see on this? Really? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Really, real. Lovely, me. What did you do? Because I made fun of her marital status, she's done this to my friend. That's not fair. That's not fair. No, I have a solution for that. The clowns and magicians always carry our magic power with us. It's very interesting. You open it, and there it is, the magic power. Laughing. See? No, she's laughing. See? I was asking you, why do we laugh? She's laughing. She's enjoying it. Your turn to pour the puppy. Yeah, good point. Good. Perfect. Now it's perfectly on. It's very simple. All you have to do is say, oh, and if you do that, see? I'm making you getting more. Hold it here. Open it and show it to them, the beautiful fan that you have in front of everybody. Open it. Not left back, yeah. Actually, fantastic, nice thing. It's very beautiful, and both hands, boom. Isn't that simple? See, not no switch, no nothing, no app in between. You just open it and show it to everybody. One, two, three. Ta-da! See, it is so easy, right? Perfect. I need you, ma'am. What's your name? My heart. Very simple. Just open it. Show it to everybody. Perfect. Fuck. You're related to each other? Cousins? Twins? You don't look like twins. Don't worry. We have magic powder. Perfectly fine now. It's still getting a little boring, right? Because you know why? She's not even opened the box. How will the magic powder come out? It is so simple. Isko bola hi nahi powder aayega kahan se bahar? Open it up. Yeah, I'll hold it. Don't worry. You need a little pressure. That's not the way. Don't scare me like that.
I am not, you are a nice person, but that excitement takes control of all of us. Right? So it's very simple.
watch carefully. One, two, three, put it there, tap. First you tap and then you say foo. No, first you say foo and then you tap. Whatever. Perfect. And the
button. Because you're
thrown
back.
Tap for it. That's a wonderful guy. Right?
My character of vision is too much.
I came to the wrong gag in perhaps. Okay, so a little back.
I'm making a point because I'm a surgeon, I have the eagle's eye. So be
aware. Aware, of course. I'm not feeling a watch at all. So now do you get why do we laugh? In the first two instances, we were laughing because they were the victims. Normally, he is the victim. Today, I was the victim with him. And you laugh because I apparently failed in my attempt. But I was destined to fail because I was showing it off to everybody anyway. We will never laugh if our neighbor hits the jackpot. Will we laugh? If he laughs, we never laugh if he gets the lottery, right? If he finds a beautiful girlfriend, will you laugh, boys? No, right? But when somebody's beautiful girlfriend ditches him and finds a better boy, see, look at that, she's so happy. See, that is happiness. Somebody's misfortune is our fortune to laugh. Isn't it? That is what happens. Somebody slips and falls and my goodness, you want to laugh but you cannot out of courtesy. So if you turn away like that. Right now, she's just doing it on her own. Some personal thing, huh? Friends! Yeah, it always normally never happens to us, it always happens to friends. Right? Thank you so much. And we'll go ahead with this. It's a very interesting thing. We always laugh at others, we never laugh at ourselves, and we never laugh after the first 5 years or 6 years of life. We never laugh when we are tickled because we don't get tickled out of that. That's the reason that phrase in English, what tickles your fancy? Right? What instigates you to laugh? And now you know what instigates you to laugh. So that is the role of happy. To provide a ready target for people to laugh. Who in the right senses would dress up like this and travel across from New Bombay to here? Tell me. No. But I want people to laugh. Because we saw all the things that happen when you laugh. There's so many things that happen. And your doctors, you must have already learned that endorphins, they call it, right? Small things or big things? Endorphins, feel good factor and all that stuff. They are supposed to accelerate the recovery process. Why not? Why don't we do that also? Right? I go to hospitals, I go to patients, I go to parents, more than if they are a cancer patient, child. Rather than the child, poor child, 4 years, 5 years, he doesn't even understand the gravity of the situation. He doesn't know the seriousness of the disease that unfortunately he is through. It is the parents who need somebody to talk to. They have, apart from the money part, they were the emotional stress, they were the medical stress, they don't have a hostel to stay, they come out of other places to Bombay. That is where people like me, I'm not the only one, there are so many of us in the country and the world. That is where we try and give them a little solace. Though I call myself Dr. Laugh a Lot, I am far from a doctor. Well, not this far, more far. I do not claim to have any medical knowledge at all because I don't have. Doctors are there to take care of the disease. They also know what I am talking, but unfortunately there are so many patients and relatively so many less doctors that you do not have the time to give to the patient, though you would want to. You would want to know each patient by name. And understand. But in that 20 minutes in the morning before you go for the rest of it, in that round you don't have time to say hi, hello to that poor child who's there. You would love to do that. Why not? That is where people like me come in to say hello to the child and say, how are you? No. We never say, how are you to the patient? Because if he was good, he would not be there. Especially me, when I meet a small child, I shake his hand, I put my hand there and he puts his hand on top of me. Because I am giving him support, I don't shake his hand. He is as it is there for a reason. So I just offer my hand, if he feels comfortable, he puts his hand on my hand and I cover it with my other hand. No boisterousness, no showing off my manly, forgy background. Not required, right? But that is how the child and I get connected. But now, okay, there is somebody who is talking to me as a person and not as the sister is narrating, okay, he had this in the morning and urine passed and all those things and that. It's statistics which the doctors accept, understanding and processing it so that he can give him a next dose of medicine or plan. He doesn't, unfortunately, have time to give for the emotional battle. That is where I come in. And now I have a challenge for the young doctors that when we go on the rounds of the wards, how many of you are ready to wear a red nose like this? At least for today. Yeah. Because, I tell you a lie. Please, thank you so much. I appreciate it. Unless, see, when I got into this 2001, and I realized that this is going to be my uniform for the rest of my life, and I accepted it, I was very, very wary of moving outside the complex. So I would come as myself, get in the car, go to the place, get into the green room, spend half an hour, 45, 1 minute there, come out, do my gig, go back. I was not sure whether people will accept me. But that was my fear. People were ready to accept me. People had no qualms about it. They got a ready reason to laugh, to smile. That's what happens at traffic junctions. People look, they smile. And perhaps 9 out of 10 will go back and tell, I met a stupid guy who was dressed up like this. I don't mind being called stupid. I don't mind being called a clown or a joker or a vidushak or a puddle. So long as somebody laughs. Because as soon as he laughs, I have connected with him. Get that? Okay, so this is the offer. I have got 10 noses with me. Okay, I will leave it with Dr. Sanchetti. I could have left it with anybody, but since I know him, I'll leave it with him. We use them during the evening when we go across to the wards. If you want to keep them, I'm going to charge you money. But if you're going to return it to me, the condition is you have to take a selfie with you wearing it and one of the patients there. How many of you came for that? So you think I'll have to carry most of my clothes back? We'll find, once you wear and once you laugh at the other person, you'll also want to wear. I'm very sure about this. Can you go to the next slide, please? Yeah, these are some of my pictures that you'll see once in a while. I love to dress up. I love not to repeat my costume or my ensemble. I keep mixing and matching. Yeah, next please. Laughter. Because you laugh, because I wear a red nose. See? It evokes a smile. There's nothing there. There's nothing here. Because long time back I got myself operated. It's here. Yeah, my doctor, my surgeon is fantastic. You can't even see the scar, see? No, he did it from this side. I'm just joking. You'll see from his eagle eye that side outside. See, this is what happens. And as soon as you laugh and I laugh, each other, we don't laugh at each other, we laugh with each other, there's a barrier that is broken. And now we are in the same team. And now you respect me and I mutually respect you. And that helps the doctor to build a rapport with the patient. The patient feels comfortable that this doctor means business, but he is also nice and he's smiling at me. I love this. Can we go to the next slide, please? I'm not saying anything, he's just telling you. Those blood pressure reduces. I mean, all of your doctors, you must have already learned this or heard this. I have a major problem when I do this and when I pitch to the hospitals or the admin people there or the director medical there. They wonder, why does this idiot want to come to my hospital? Do everything for free and then go back. What is in it for him? I'm a sadist, am I? That I want to see patients who are suffering. Does it give me joy? No, it does not. When I go back with a little heavy heart. But I'm seeing those innocent children suffering for no reason. But like I was talking to somebody, normally a hospital will only entertain me, unlike today, this is a very positive thing I've seen today, they will only call me for 14 November, 25th December, or around between 25th December and 1st of January. Or the trustee's mother's or grandmother's birthday. Right? What about the rest of the 360 plus days? Don't you have that maxim, laughter is the best medicine for those days also? Everybody agrees, but when I go there, let's see, but the team is coming, MHA team is coming, this team is coming. No, we've got a round, no, bachon ka exam hai. I appreciate. I know one small fear that they have, that this clown will come one day, come 2 days, come 1 week, one month regularly, and next day when I come, instead of carrying Dr. Lapalot, I will carry somebody, some pharma company's logo. They have the fear. Otherwise, why would I do it? But they don't know that this is my way of earning happiness for myself. It's very difficult to tell it to them. Fortunately, now with the documentary, the videos coming in, I've started breaking into it. But otherwise, they have a very logical and a practical question to me. Why do you want to do that? Aren't we good enough? I'm not challenging their duties at all. Can we go to the next slide? Yes. There'll be one more coming up. Can you remember? Yes, see? I knew that. I have a very special song that I sing at various times. If you want, you can join me. If you don't want, again, you can join me. Right? It's called a happy song. See? Because I'm happy. It's my song. It's the happy song. You want to go or you want to see something else which is going to give you nice happiness? Yeah? You know the voice from real? Yeah. Nobody wants to meet my eye now. Come on, boys. Your two girls were here. But he falls in the senior category, so I'm talking about boys. He's a man. I'm a man. Yeah, boys category? Nobody? Yes, sir, you? The one with the glasses there, second last row. Oh, he's turning behind. He knows he's second last row. He's fantastic. I love you, sir. Do you have a handkerchief in your pocket? Yes. Wonderful. Your name, sir? And I'm not going to ask you that question. You know which question? You don't know. Perfect. Perfect. I'm not going to ask you if you're married or not. Why should I ask you? I don't know which pocket you kept your handkerchief. Okay? Hold the handkerchief and bring it out. You also use white? Almost. Yes. Just it out. I want to teach you magic. Don't worry. No handkerchief back. With the handkerchief. Right, sir? Put it on and power it out. Hold the tip of the center. Yeah? Right? Now don't do anything. Just watch me. Okay, then I will teach you how to do it. Hold it like this and then wait there. Now the magic comes. Okay? Hold this there nicely. Say the magic word. That is magic word. Laughing at me. You don't know how big a magician I am, 94 kgs. If you do that correctly, you have the handkerchief under your spell. Yeah? Not skull then. Spell. And you say, come. Come, 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 come. See that, sir? See? It's so interesting. You say, go, 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 go. It goes. You want to do it?
Yes.
Yeah, do that. Hold it there. Do that. Wow! Lovely. And now, tell it, come, 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 come. See, you learned it? See, you learned that? Magic is so easy. You do this in front of your friends or their children or something and they are going to love. Next thing is you hold it there, twist it 3 times. See, this is surgery, it always helps. See, it always works because I am pressing the finger, not there. Right? No, this was just a joke, put it back in the thing. I was going to tell you a story actually, but it's called mind reading. You know what's mind reading? No? Even I don't know. Oh, sorry. Take the handkerchief off again. It's very important to take it up. Yep. Over there. Same thing again. This time again, you take it out. Yep. Look where it is little. Yeah? Okay? Don't go anywhere, I'll come back in a second. Keep watching my hand. Bad news. This effect that I'm going to show you just sharing a secret with you. This is about 180 years old and it has never failed. Magicians have been doing it for 180 years and more, and this has never failed. All you got to do is take all you got to do is take this and cut it. Very simple.
Mom is going to kill
me. Don't tell her this. It's your turn. I didn't hesitate. You're a doctor. You're going to be a doctor, right?
I'm
here. No, no, go ahead. Don't worry. Nothing will happen. He can cut it. There's no problem in that. See, just come there, cut it. Yeah, exactly. He can cut it. There's no problem. It's so easy. You just have to be able to take a deep breath, hold it, and then cut it. Oh, I know. I know. Okay, cut it. I'm not moving. Want to hold it? You know why I cut his handkerchief? Because if I had cut mine and I would have asked him to cut his, he would never cut it. Right? But since I had already cut his handkerchief, now he's not worried about my handkerchief. Right? He was just pretending, ah, I mean, I can't cut it at all. Now he's very... Okay, put that knife away, enough. Where's the piece? He's there, right?
Yes.
Take a deep breath. Boys, 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 wait. Boys, be careful when you take a deep breath. Your stomach tends to go inside. You get it, right? Yeah, gravity takes charge of your trousers then. Don't laugh. Nothing is happening, he's wearing a belt. Am I not? Okay, hold it then. And push it back into the fist. Don't worry at all, I'm there with you. Okay? Put your hand in your pocket. The magic powder that I gave you before coming here, you can drop it there. Whom did you give it to? Not him? No, don't say that. I told him, plant one. I mean, he was supposed to be a stood, match fixing guy. Mm. He's not the same boy? Are you the same person I gave it to now? I'm so confused. Whom did I give it to? Okay, doesn't matter. Just put it there, it'll be okay. Don't worry. I'm a big magician. Put it there. Don't worry. Put that inside, squeeze it in nicely, take it out. Put it there, down, down, down. Perfect. Now it's the magic. Done. Stand like that. Okay, hold one corner. Okay, don't do anything right now. Let me give you a demo. Hold this in your hand. Take one step forward when I say one. Okay? Not now. Just watch the demo. Dust it, open it, show it to everybody and see the way they clap. Okay, magic happens. Trust me, I know what I'm doing. Okay, I knew what I was doing, that's the reason I cut his hand. It's very easy, it always works. See, 180 years of experience, it never fails. Yeah, somebody's already getting their mobiles ready. Yeah. Ready, sir?
Yes.
3, 2, 1, dust it, open it, and show it to everybody and try. Wrong boy, he didn't come here.
I sold it.
You that is your happiness? Nowhere during the time since the time I have come and until now, nobody had laughed so louder until now. Because this was material loss for him. Right? Everybody's so happy you lost your either day of friends. Most of them? Now you know. Now you know, right? Thank you, sir. Oh yeah, that's fine. In my show, there is no sadness. Because I am happy. And last 180 years, tell you, anybody who's come to help the magician, it has never worked for him. It has only worked for the magician for the 180 years past. For the person who comes to assist him or give a demo, it never works. So we magicians always carry a brand new, yeah, exactly, just brand new and fresh, a new handkerchief, and people normally don't take it, but
अंदर भी देखो, you're talking to a clown. Fair? Fair? Okay, you want to take your handkerchief back, if you're too attached to it, you can take it. At least show Mama you got a replacement. Does she wonder who's presenting him a handkerchief? Have a girlfriend? Then it's okay. But they say you should not gift handkerchiefs, right? You know it? Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. That's what I was saying. If you have to get somebody else's, you go for the song now. It's a very simple song, four lines only. You can repeat the lines after me if you want. Can we have it, sir? Hang on. He said, the time to be happy is now.
The time to be happy is now.
The place to be happy is here.
The place to be happy is here.
And the way to be happy.
And the way to be happy.
Is to make someone happy.
Is to make someone happy.
And make your little heaven.
Make your little heaven.
Right here.
Right here.
You give happiness, you get back happiness. You sow sorrow, you'll only get sorrow. You give me seeds of trees, I'll only get positive results from there. Thank you so much for being such a wonderful crowd. I hope it helps you somewhere down the line in your life. If it doesn't, blame me, nobody else. One more thing that I missed out saying, we still have time for 5 minutes? Not even 5 minutes, 2 minutes. Nobody owes you your happiness, not even your parents. You owe your happiness to yourself. You got to find it, you got to nurture it, you got to cherish it. Whatever makes you happy, so long as it is not illegal. It might be fattening, but not illegal. It is okay. Right? Most of the happinesses are fattening. So indulge, so long as it is not illegal in the country, do that also. Right? Thank you so much. All the very best. Happy birthday. No. Oh, good. That's so sweet. I stand to my promise. I have actually got a bunch of noses. Okay? They are very easy to wear. Who's going to be the first one to wear and try, and then you can take it off? Come here. You're such a good boy. It's a split sponge nose. It may not stay on the nose for a long time. If you keep it like that, lovely. Okay? So you have a very skin friendly, I have tried it for the last 20 years. Now nothing happens. A little running nose after 2 days, but today nothing will happen. Okay? Just put a little dab here, a little dab here. Stick it. And if the patient does not give you a second look, I will let him. Okay? I've got more, they're all returnable. Otherwise I charge 1,000 rupees per piece. And he'll be paying for that. You're so happy. Always, right? I've got two more props that I'm going to share for the evening. One is a lovely, beautiful puppet. Anybody can wear it. When you speak to the child exactly like this, he will be very, very happy. Right? But if you already do it, I can show you how to do it with your handkerchief. It's very simple. You just need a handkerchief. Put it on your hand like this. Take one corner. Pull it through. Pull the other corner. Pull it through. Push it inside. These become ears. That becomes a nose. And you've got a small little rabbit there. Okay? It works beautifully. Try it out. And as soon as you're doing something, the child gets interested. He forgets what unfortunately he's going through. Right? Try it out. Thanks for being there. I will be sharing this also, and there's something more in the back. And of course, balloons and the balloon pump that will go and use it inside. As soon as they're ready to go. Right? I'll just pack my stuff. And my magic wands are there.
Thank you so much, sir, for joining us. Now we'll be going to the PEDS Award, Award number 2. So all those interested could join us. And now I'd just like Lupa Ma'am to request Lupa Ma'am present Happy Uncle with a small token of appreciation.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for joining us.
Pleasure.
For sharing your journey.
Thank you, ma'am. Here, of course.
Do you think this was a good idea? Yes.
Yes.
Acknowledging somebody's presence always makes them happy. Anytime. When you look into the eye and say thank you again, it makes a lot of difference. Try it not only with her, try it. How many of you hug your dad or mom every day? Only girls? Only boys? That is happiness. Give it to your dad at any age. Especially the boys, try it. He wants it, but you're not giving it to him. Okay? He will behave, he's embarrassed, but he's not, he's happy. Right, sir? Everybody loves to be hugged. I've got a grown-up son, much grown up, he's working, but today I don't care if he likes it or not. He also returns the hug back, but I hug him in public. Try it, it's a beautiful feeling and it really makes everybody happy. I tell the young boys and girls when I meet the school children that there's a small secret. As soon as you hug your mama before going to sleep or before going to bed, you'll never have bad dreams. Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, so we'll now be heading to Pediatric Ward 2, to entertain the kids over there. And after that, we'll be heading to Pediatric Ward 1 and Psychiatry Ward 9. So everybody is.